Welcome back. 6:54 here on the show. Now, after 25 years of focusing just on women, the Look Good, Feel Better workshops are turning their attention now to men. The charity initiative helps people deal with the effects of cancer treatment in a positive way. Here to explain more is General Manager Clare O'Higgins. Clare, so nice to have you on. And wonderful news that the program is such a success is that you can expand it to men. And tell us how this came about.
Thank you. I mean, thank you so much for the opportunity to talk about Look Good, Feel Better. And the opportunity to look at the workshops for men really came about from some research we were doing to say, is this a need for the men? But also, a man happened to be diagnosed with cancer, and he'd seen his wife go through the program 5 years ago, had seen the impact that it had had on her, on her confidence, and went on and said, I want some of that, please. And we really started the program to see whether or not we could help men like him feel confident and in control at a time when so much is taken out of control.
And I read what the workshops do is they, for just for a small amount of time, make that person feel like a person and not a patient, was the expression I read. Tell us exactly what they do, because it talks through, you said, tips and tricks to help you cope with what your body's going to be going through as a result of the treatment.
Absolutely. So for the last 25 years in New Zealand for the women and teenagers, we've been able to run workshops for over 2.5 hours. We're able to focus on you, Clare, the person, not Clare, the cancer patient. And we talk about the skincare regime, the importance of actually taking care of that as you undergo any form of treatment, nail care, and then we talk about the ability to be able to camouflage or to actually reframe your face by redrawing your eyebrows, giving you a sense of eyelashes, and giving you wig care and advice. And exactly the same thing happens for the men, in as much that skin tone changes, we need to talk about skin care, nail care, some of the things that guys just don't think about on a normal life, but when you're undergoing treatment you really need to know about those things. And then while we'll talk about the eyebrows, we don't actually make them redraw them as we do with the women, except in every class at the end we hang back and a couple of men will always come back and just go, can you just show me how to do those eyebrows again? Because they want to feel in control, and again, they want to look like James, they don't want to look like cancer. And often, we're the best kept secret because people want to keep working without people knowing that they're actually undergoing cancer treatment. And if you can actually continue on with your role, feeling that you're still your person, that's the best form of well-being and confidence we can give while people are fighting their treatment.
Try and keep some sort of sense of normality during it.
Totally.
It seems so obvious, doesn't it, really, now, I guess, now that it's been added, because going through those things would be equally as traumatic for any man as it would be for any woman.
Yeah, I think we all get that sense that, you know, a man can sort of handle any of these things and we're used to shaving heads and things like that, but for a man it's equally traumatic when you're actually undergoing all the regimes that you are and all the intervention, that you've actually got something that you can actually go back and say, I can do this for me. But it's so much more than just for me, because it impacts the family, and when the family see that you're back feeling more confident and in control, they feel more comfortable that actually things are going the way that they would like it to go.
Wow, good for everyone, isn't it? I know some of the makeup artists from here help out with some of the workshops, and they say it is just a brilliant, brilliant day. Clare Higgins, thank you so much for coming in and talking about your program.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for your time.